All these things we have covered, I can remember. Ambiguity, CFG regular expression. Useless. These things we have done now. Left recursion. Can anybody respond? Very charming. Yes, yes, we have done this. Left factoring we have done. No. Eliminate left recursion, these things. Okay, I understand. So we start from left recursion, that will be better. Give me 1 minute. So I think you remember what is left recursion. When we call some grammar is a left recursive grammar. When we find that the same symbol is arriving on both sides of the arrow, you can say. Okay, so here you can see this is the basic definition of recursor. Left recursion is that it happens when you get something like this A to A alpha. Now this alpha can be anything. It can be any combination of terminals and non-terminals. Okay, now this is we call immediate left recursion. That means after this arrow, immediately we are getting this head symbol at the beginning. Immediately we are getting it. So we call it immediate left recursion. Okay. But sometimes it may not be immediate. Okay. So like you can see here, what it is saying that after a few, one or more and derivation, the situation can arise. So that what will happen? You have started with, driving with A. After some time, at the leftmost position, you are getting A again. Again, it is something the same situation what you had here, right? With this A. Again, if you, start with A, expand this A or drive from this A, after some time again you are going to get another A. Okay. If this is the situation, then we write the left recursion like this. That means instead of immediately, in this case if you see, you start with A, immediately you get A at the left hand, as a leftmost non-terminal, and other things will be there. So again, what will happen? We are doing left, still now, what we have started, that we was doing leftmost derivation, right? Leftmost derivation we was doing. So left hand symbol is a. If we start again with, we have to apply this rule. Second, it will give a and alpha and so on. This thing will be continuously, recurringly happen. So that is the reason we are calling it as left recursion. So top-down parsing technique cannot handle left recursive grammar. Okay? So we were speaking about top-down parsing technique. So you can remember that in top-down parsing technique, we do leftmost derivation and we read the inputs from left to right. So as we do leftmost derivation, so if we get this left recursive protection rule in the grammar, it is going to, going to put us on a left recursive process. So we have to convert our left recursive grammar into an equivalent grammar which is not left recursive. Understand? So our point is that what is our target if we want to continue with top-down parsing? If we want to continue with top-down parsing, and this top-down parsing can't handle left recursive grammars, okay, this left recursion can be handled by the top-down parsing. So what do we need to do? If we want to use this left recursive grammar into top recursive parsing, top-down parsing, then only thing is there in our hand, remove the left recursion. So next thing is that how to remove, right? Now here is something we need to notice. We can remove left recursion if we have our grammar in this form. That means you can say one production is there A to A alpha and another production is there A to beta. Okay, then only, if this is the situation, then only we can do, remove the left recursion, okay? So how we can do? These two production rules, we rewrite as this. We introduce a new variable A dash, and we do A to beta A dash. Okay, so this is a new variable, then we do A dash to alpha A dash. Now as A dash is a new variable, you have to keep a scope that A dash can be, it can be possible to make null. So we add this. Okay, so you can see what we have done. We had two production rules, this and this. And we have created three production rules, this, this, and this. And by adding one new non-terminal. Okay. Now, immediate left recursion, what I was telling you, that if the left recursive symbol is arriving immediately after this arrow or immediately at the beginning of the body, then we call it immediate left recursion. And this is the way I have already shown you in the previous one, that using this method we can rewrite the left recursive grammar into non-left recursive form. So here, if we take the first one, A to E plus T or T. Now, if you compare this production rule, if you compare this production rule with this and this, then what you will find that this E can be compared with A. So A, you know, E is comparing with A. Then we have alpha here, right? Alpha here. Alpha. So this part you can compare with alpha, and this T you can compare with beta. So we got in the same form, right? So we can rewrite this as E2, beta is there, T, E dash, need a new variable, a new non-terminal, and E dash 2, beta, sorry, not beta, alpha, E dash, right? So what is our alpha? Beta plus T is our alpha. So plus T and E dash. Alright? And finally, what you need to do? E dash to epsilon. So for this production rule, we have to, this production rule, we have to write like this so that there will be no left recursion for this production rule. We have another production rule which is having left recursion, that is T2 T multiplication F or F. So again, T can be compared with A. Multiplication F can be treated as alpha, and this L, so this F can be treated as beta. So we can rewrite it like this. T2 beta is F here, T dash, and T dash 2 alpha T dash, right? And finally T dash 2 epsilon. So this is what we have to write in place of these two rules. Okay, and finally we will have a grammar where there will be no left recursion, and if there is no left recursion, we can use it for our top-down parsing technique. Okay, so this was our original grammar. After doing removing left recursion, this become the resultant grammar. Okay. So there is another kind of left recursion called intermediate left recursion. Okay. So what is intermediate left recursion? That in this, what happens in multiple places, multiple rules are there which are occurring your left recursion. Okay, so in this case you can see only one pair is there in this, A to A alpha. But if you have a situation like this, you have something A to A alpha 1, then again you have another rule A to A alpha 2, A to A alpha 3, okay, like this. So in this case, we can remove the left recursion if with each of the, A alpha 1, A alpha 2, A alpha 3, we can get 3 beta also. Okay, if we also have A2 beta 1, A2 beta 2, A2 beta 3, understand? If we get this set also, like here, we can remove this left recursion if we get A2 beta, that means this is, right, A2 beta. Then only we can do the same thing, okay? And definitely this beta does not start with A, understand? This beta does not start with A. So how we can rewrite it? look at this. Hey, another thing is there. This number of alpha and number of beta may not be same. Okay, so for doing this disbalance, I'm adding here. Okay, this is not going to be me, it is slept. Okay, no issue. Okay, so I have written here 4. Okay, so number of alpha and number of beta may not be equal, but thing is that you need to have a set of rule like this, which you will have A to alpha, sorry, A to beta, and definitely some left recursive rules like this, which are having A to A alpha form. Okay. Then in that case, we can rewrite this left recursive grammar or production rules as like this. A2, we have 3 alpha, sorry, 3 beta. Okay, so we can write A2 beta 1 A dash, A2 beta 2 A dash, and A2 beta 3 A dash, right? So all three betas are being used. Next, you have to add rule for A dash, right? So A dash 2, what we had added in this case, if you see, we had added A dash to alpha A dash, right? So for all the alpha, you have 4 alphas here, okay? So alpha 1 A dash. Yeah, alpha 1 A dash, then A dash 2, alpha 2, A dash 2, alpha 3, yes, alpha 3, A dash 2, alpha 4, A dash. And one more production rule you have to add, that is A dash to epsilon. Understand? So if you have a similar production rule like this in multiple cases, R1 is all are similar, right? So if this happens in multiple production rules in a single grammar, then we can rewrite it like this. Okay. So, what is the problem of removing the left recursion or everything? So, a grammar cannot be immediately left recursive, but it still can be left recursive. So, here you can see, here after removing, here there is no left recursion, here there is no immediate left recursion, but you can see if you this alpha becomes, we have something like this, A dash to alpha A dash, and so due to some reason this alpha is becoming, due to some reason this alpha is becoming, say, epsilon. If your alpha gives epsilon, then what? Then again you are falling into left recursion in an indirect way. So this is something we are speaking about. Okay, so but it still can be left recursive by just eliminating the immediate left recursion. We may not get grammar which is not left recursive. So by only doing this, we may be in a situation that our grammar is not become effectively left recursive grammar. Okay, so here if you see something is here, another example, see the production rules. You have S to A, capital A small a, or B, and capital A to SC. So if this is the situation, so what can happen if we start with, sorry, if we start with S, okay, and we choose this A to A, and after that, if we choose this A to S C, again from this S I have to drive, and when you're driving, I'm choosing that S to A, and this A to S, and so on. So what is going to happen? It is not immediately falling you in left recursive, okay, but still it is a kind of left recursion, or it is having left recursion, due to this this thing. S is pointing to A, and A is pointing to S, right? So due to this, this is becoming a left recursion situation. So we must eliminate all left recursion from our grammar. So it is this is what to understand, and what is our target. So here is a algorithm eliminating left recursion. So you can see here we have two for loops. Replaces production in for like this, ai to aj gamma to ai to alpha 1 gamma alpha 2 gamma and so on, and where aj equal to alpha 1 alpha can be. So eliminate immediate left recursion among ai production. So understanding this algorithm is not so important if you understood these parts, okay, because nobody is going to ask you these algorithms, but you have to understand that this part, in GATE and in other competitive exam, you may get some questions from this part. Okay. Now, example 2 here is eliminate the left recursion. So how we can do it? Here you can look at this very minutely. Where is the left recursion? You can find here. There is two kind of things. Okay, first, see what are the non-terminals are given here. Okay. If you see, we have two non-terminals, A to A and S. Okay. And if you see very minutely, S is pointing to what? The first one, S is pointing to A, or small a is there. Okay. So, and in this next production rule, if you see A to SD, we have A to SD. So definitely, S is pointing to A, A is pointing to S, right? And A is pointing to S. So this is what going to give you a left recursion. Okay. So this is what going to give you some left recursion. So what you can do? We do not enter in the inner loop. There is no immediate left recursion in the S. If you just compare with this algorithm, as there is no immediate left recursion, okay, so it is not going into the inner loop. Okay, now if you forget about this part, now you consider A. For A, we are going to get this production rule A to SC. Okay, so this is one production rule, and A to AC, and another we are going to get, that is A to SD. Right, so what we can do here, look at this very carefully. If if we do something, you know, this HD is there. If we just do A2, you know, use this first production rule, S2, S2, capital A. Right, so capital A bring here, and already I have D here. Right. So, we are using this production rule. Using S2, this. I can come to this point, right? I can come to this point. Now, what I have? I have A to AD, A to AC here also, I have, right? And I already, so if all this together, this one, and this one, if I write together, then what we are going to get? We are going to get a situation like A2, AC, or A2, AAD, or S, sorry. And yeah, this S can again, this S can again replace with small b, right? So in that case, from here we can get A2 S is replaced by small b and D, right? So using which rule we have done this? Capital S to B, right? So by this we have A to BD as well with us, right? A to BD we have, and we have epsilon. Now look at this situation very carefully. We are in a situation where we have alpha 1, alpha 2, beta 1, beta 2, correct? So if this is the situation, what was the rule we have followed, we have seen previously? We have to do A to beta 1, so sorry, I should not write beta 1 here, our beta 1 is what? Our beta 1 here is BD. So A to BD, A dash will add first, then beta 2 is epsilon, epsilon A dash will add. Next, for A dash, we have to add the production rule. So what will be the production rule? Alpha 1 A dash, that means here alpha 1 is C, C A dash, and alpha 2 is AD, AD, A dash, right? And finally, we have to add another rule for A dash, you know, that is A dash to epsilon. Okay, so this is one example of if you have multiple left reduction. Okay, so the resulting equivalent grammar, which is not left recursive, can be written like, can be written like what? S to A or B, then A to a dash, and epsilon a dash is there, so epsilon no need to write a dash, okay, then a dash 2 c a dash we have, and a d a dash we have, or a d a dash, and finally a dash to epsilon. Okay, now we like to remove the useless production. Like, we have any useless production here? No, we don't have any useless production. Okay, this is a to a dash, so you can keep this as it is. Or you can just write, it can be, this can be, up to this it is enough to get good marks, but after this you can just optimize this, because this is a unit production we have. Unit production means non-terminal to non-terminal, a to a dash, right? So these three, this, you know, in the box, these rules can be rewritten as a to a d a dash and this production rule can be revoked, because if I do this, just a to a dash and a dash to something. Okay, yeah, so we can just do this. So a to a dash, you know, this you can remove, and we can rewrite these rules like this: a to b d a dash, then a to this unit production I just derived out, so a to c a dash, then a to a d a dash, and finally a dash to epsilon. Okay, so this can be way of rewriting it. Okay, so this is the result what we have just solved. Okay, next.